What's going on, guys? Tommy Oka back, and welcome to my full tutorial on how to use WorldPainter. So WorldPainter is an awesome application you can use to make a custom Minecraft world. So one of the very first things you can actually do with this is you can change the dimensions of how much of the world you're customizing. Like right here, you click File and New World, and just like this, this thing pops up, and you can just type in whatever you want to. You can do, just call this tutorial, and you put it to beta 1.15 or later. That will work the best with 1.16.5, which is the version of Minecraft that is out currently at the time of filming. And you can also, you know, go up like this. You can make it 2,304 blocks by 3,000. You can go up to 10,000. You can go 4,000. It doesn't matter all that much. Just whatever you want to do, you can choose. You can also make it circular if you want to, whatever you want. It also gives you walking times. As you can see, west to east is 17 minutes and north to south is 16 minutes. That is in-game time it would take to go from both of those sides to the other. Like west to east, it would take 17 minutes of in-game Minecraft walking. That is because these dimensions are not the same. You can change the topography just like this. You know, as you can see, you can just go up with the hill size or go down or change the horizontal hill size down. You can do whatever you want to with those. You can also change it to flat and change the level down a bit. You can not only change the level of the ground, you can change the level of the water. You can change the water level all the way down to zero and then change the level of the land down to one. You can change the surface material, you know, to whatever Minecraft block you want to. You could go advanced and you could configure it advanced, but I normally just go simple, and you can do a land Minecraft seed and create. And just like that, your world has been created. And this application has custom controls. So your mouse wheel, the mouse wheel button, you push down on the mouse wheel button and then it allows you to move it just like this. But you push control while scrolling and that's how you zoom in and out. So what you can do is you can select your terrain, you can select grass, and then you can just do fill. And you can also make custom humongous mountain ranges for your custom map worlds. All you have to do is choose a brush and you choose this tool right here, and then you can scroll to make your brush selection bigger or smaller, and then you can left click and it raises and right click and it shrinks. And then you can do Control Z on Windows to go back and undo what you have done. But also, not only can you just use these brushes, I will leave links to these custom brushes that make it look more natural in the description. You can raise these mountains and it makes it look a lot more natural when you use these custom brushes. As you can see, when you can just, you know, go like this, just use it like a normal brush, you know, just do kind of like little motions. And as you can see, this is gonna look like a really cool Minecraft mountain. You can drag outwards to make it less intense, or you can lower at the edges to make it a more intense mountain. Whatever you want works for this. And also, on a normal world, you have these selections. You can fill it with water. You click, and wherever you click, it will fill it with water. And there you go. There is your custom island Minecraft world. Just like that, you can make yourself a custom island. Or you could also make yourself a custom volcano world. Instead of having water, you could flood it with lava. You know, and if you have a mess up like this, you can use this tool right there next to it to dry areas. As you can see, you can just brush. And just like that, as you see, this dries up the areas. So all you have to do is just brush. It'll dry up what you previously did wrong. Or you could just do Control Z and just undo everything. And just like that, it's back to normal. And it will have these glitch spots occasionally that you might have to just erase manually. It's not perfect. Sometimes these happen. Not everything is perfect. You can also not only undo things that you do, you can also change the rotation of the brush and the intensity of what you're doing. So just like this, I have popped on a new world to show you some more things. So you can select that height, raise, or lower tool again. You can go to the custom brushes that are linked in the description. Just download the folder, and all you have to do to insert the custom brushes is click Tools and click Open Custom Brushes Folder. And you drag the PNGs. They should be named exactly like these because it will be the same exact ones that are in my custom brushes. So moving on, you not only can raise the landscape like this, you know, you not only can lower, you know, make valleys and raise sections and raise huge mountains like this. You can also smooth, flatten, and raise mountains just like default. Just like, you know, just default. You can go like this and just raise mountains default like it does in this. But it's easier if you just use the classic raise or lower because it makes it look better. Even with the mountain tool looking like that, you can click on the smooth and you can just smoothen out the terrain by holding left click and dragging it over the landscape. And as you can see, it smoothens everything out. I can quickly just spike one of these mountains out like crazy. Just spike a few mountains and show you what the smoothing tool does. Right here, you have those two big mountains. They're too extreme. You click smooth, you know, and all you got to do is just drag over them like this and it will smoothen out those hills just like that. Not only can you use the classic terrain editing tools right here, you can also use the pyramid tools that will raise pyramids just like this. If you wanted to make a big pyramid, you know, you wanted to make a modified desert temple, and you could just make a big pyramid and go off of that. As you can see, you can make diagonal pyramids, normal pyramids. You can do whatever with these, and you could also smooth them out if you want to. But I recommend only using the pyramids if you are actually building a pyramid. What you can also do is you can click this to change the spawn point. As you can see, spawn point there. You can put the spawn point here. You can put the spawn point there. You can put the spawn point here. You can put the spawn point wherever you want it to be. Now to show you the intensity and rotation. If you click pencil, click terrain, and you know, choose which block you want to do. Say you want magma blocks. You can have your brush. As you can see, I will set that to my brush. I will turn the intensity up and I will make it rotated. And as you can see, my little box that I can, you know, change the brush size and stuff right here that's around my cursor is diagonal. So it just changes the orientation of the exact of the brush. So if you want to use, you know, this one right here that I'm using, or this one that's straight, as you can see, it changes the rotation. You can rotate it this way. You can rotate it this all the way up. It doesn't really matter exactly, but the intensity, if you put it down and brush, then it changes and it puts less of that amount. So if you're using the spray can tool, the spray paint tool, which is subtly integrating it into the landscape just like this, then the intensity, if you turn it up to 100, then it, you know, it makes a lot more transition. You know, if you want to go on the edge of this little section, if you want to make it subtly transition into the landscape, you can put some of these, sprinkle these around the outside of it to make it, you know, transition to it a little bit better. And as you can see, if you have the intensity all the way up, it has a lot of them. But if you lower the intensity and do it like, you know, let's do it on the one down here, it has a lot less and is a lot more subtle. Not only is there blocks and spawn point and everything else you can change, like height and everything, you can change biomes too. Just like this, you can select plains, forest, swamp, badlands, and all of the other biomes. You can also use ocean right here. You know, as you can see, you can make that water an ocean biome. You can turn up the intensity back to default, which is 50, and then zoom in right here and make this an ocean biome. And even you can make, let's say you want to have plains on one side of this map and dark forest on the other. All you have to do is you can click show and it shows you the biomes, and you can just drag and brush. And when you're doing biomes, make sure you have the pencil tool selected so it's full. It's like a full entire stroke. As you can see, the sand went darker because that's plains biome now, just like that. You can make plains biome. You can change all this to plains biome. And as you can see, the biome actually, the color changes for the biome. And you can turn, if you turn off the terrain, it shows you the biome. So this is all plains. And then that has been overlaid because I drew over it. You could also go back to the biomes, select forest, and then it has an icon that makes that section forest. And let's say you want this to be swamp. There you go. You have your swamp. And then you want this to be your badlands right here. And then you want, oh, let's say you want your beach. You want a beach biome here. You can have your desert, you know, surrounding it. You know, whatever you want to do, just like this. And you can turn the terrain back on and it overlays it. And you can see which sections are the biomes of your choice. But if you enjoyed my basic tutorial on how to use World Painter, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. See you in another video.